So how fast can you become a programmer? So in other words, how fast can you learn the technology and understand programming? Let's talk about that in today's video. This video is brought to you by the Learn Programming Academy's Master MATLAB through Guided Problem Solving course. Become an expert in MATLAB programming and scientific computing. Advance your career in engineering, physics, biology, and more. Visit lpa.dev/YouTube MATLAB or click on the link in the description below. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And this video is in relation to a question I get asked fairly often by students. And how fast can I learn to program is the question. And that's typically from someone who's just starting out in a course and they're very keen and eager to get started, but they want to know, they want to put a time frame on when they're going to quote unquote become a programmer, when they're going to understand programming. Well, the answer is that it's not really possible to necessarily figure that out in advance, because a lot of this comes down to factors that only you can control. Firstly, how much time have you got to allocate to this endeavor? And people can have 1 or 2 hours a day. Other people can have 30 minutes a week available. So it really does depend on how much time you've got, the technology you're learning, your aptitude for understanding it, like for example, your logic skills. And I've got another video that talks about to logic, so check that out up here if you're interested in that. But learning logic is a key part of programming, so you'll need to understand that. So some of the basics can take quite a while if you haven't had any experience in that field. But look, I think you're asking the wrong question. This is the truth here, that if you're coming from that mindset of how fast am I going to learn this, I think you need to take a step back and think, well, okay, I want to learn programming, but I want to learn it properly. So learning fast often means you're taking shortcuts. That's the reality. Like, if you want to get to point A to point B as quickly as you can, often you have to, you basically have to jettison some information along the way. So you have to decide that you're not going to learn this aspect, or you'll gloss over other areas because you just want to get to that stage of quote unquote being a programmer. That's the wrong mindset, in my opinion. What you need to do is just think, okay, I want to become a programmer. I want to learn this technology, and I'm going to take as long as it takes to get there. Now, that's not to say it should take 10 years, obviously, and it's not going to take 10 years either. That's the other thing. But if you're putting a time frame on yourself, you're just adding all this pressure to get yourself to that end point, and you're going to be rushing through, and you're not really going to be taking care to understand the material that is being shown to you if you're going through a course or an ebook or boot camp or whatever it is. So make sure you don't necessarily put hard limits on how long it's going to take. And just realize it's going to take as long as it takes, within reason. I mean, you might decide that you can give yourself to maybe to the end of the year, for example. That's better than saying I need to learn by next month. Because I've literally had students who'll ask me, "Can I get my first programming job in a month's time?" And they've had no programming experience. Well, no, almost certainly that's not going to happen. I mean, that's the reality in almost any industry that is skilled in the similar lines to programming. You're not going to start with no experience to getting a great paying job in a month's time. I mean, it just would be very unlikely. It's possible, I guess, anything's possible, but very unlikely. So try not to give yourself a hard constraint, but also realize it's not going to be years. You can basically work at it, just keep working at it consistently and reassess where you are on a regular basis. Because the other thing that is important with this is as you progress, and you're learning, you pick up a language, say you start with Java or Kotlin or C++ or C# or whatever it is, you might decide, once you've been through part of one of those courses, that, okay, I think I know where I want to go now. I want to get more into programming games, for example. Then you'd maybe choose the C# route because that's Unity 3D is a great framework, or Xamarin are two great platforms, cross-platform packages or frameworks to enable you to create games and other apps across platforms. So basically, the more you understand, and I've talked about in another video, the four principles of becoming a programmer, four stages, if you will. So check out that video as well if you're interested in that. But just realize that this is a journey. Try not to put these artificial time constraints on yourself, and just realize that it's going to take as long as it takes, and try and enjoy that journey. Remember, don't just focus on the destination, but try and enjoy the journey along the way. Be thorough with your training. Go through it all systematically and really try and understand what you're going through, and not trying to gloss over, not trying to rush ahead, because that's ultimately going to give you the better skills that you need to become a programmer and to make the most of those skills when you start getting into more advanced areas of programming. So good luck with it all, and just try not to put artificial time constraints on how long it's going to take. It's going to take as long as it takes. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.